Welcome to the Arefco Service Group YouTube channel. Please remember to subscribe and ring that bell to get notified whenever we upload a new video. Capacitor is a passive two-terminal electrical component that stores electricity and then releases it. That effect is called capacitance. Capacitors come in many shapes and sizes, and these are the most common sizes and shapes used in HVACR. On general use motors, they often are mounted on the side like this. In HVACR, they are often mounted external to the motor for easier access. In this case, it is mounted with the other electrical components away from the motors. This one is mounted on the side of the blower housing because it is easier to access than if it were mounted on the motor itself. Capacitors are measured in farads and microfarads. The greater the number, the more electrons of electricity it will hold. Construction of a capacitor is fairly straightforward. There are two strips of foil separated by a dielectric material. The dielectric material is the secret sauce of the capacitor. It keeps the electricity from flowing from one foil strip to the other until it has reached the amount of electrons it is designed to hold, and then it releases them across the strip. So let's take a look. We will power up this motor and the electricity flows from L2 through the run winding to L1. It also flows to our capacitor where it is halted while the dielectric material absorbs the electrons and then it releases it. As you can see in the sine wave above, this causes the sine wave of the capacitor to lag behind. Without the capacitor, we would only get power during this part of the cycle. It's kind of like getting a twofer. We get double the power for the same amount of voltage. That's not really true, but sort of. It also energizes the start winding at a different time as the run winding, giving the motor more power for the same amount of electricity. In HVACR, there are two types of capacitors, run and start. Run capacitors are continuous duty and are designed for a 12 to 15 year lifespan. They are normally a metal can filled with oil. It should be noted, in the past, the oil would contain PCBs, which can cause cancer. It would be rare to come across one today, but you should be aware of this. The run capacitor is permanently wired between the run and start terminals of a permanent split capacitor motor. Run capacitors have a low potential terminal and it should always be wired so it connects to the run winding and not the start winding. Oftentimes in outdoor units with PSC motors, you will have a dual run capacitor. It is for both the compressor and the outdoor fan motor. They are wired up in a pretty straightforward fashion. HERM stands for compressor and fan for the fan motor. Don't get them confused as they require different farad settings. Start capacitors are usually physically bigger than run capacitors. They also tend to be larger in capacitance values. Their capacitance rating come in a range instead of a set number like in run capacitors. This is because the phase shift produced by an AC current through a start capacitor doesn't need to be as precise to get the motor turning. Also, start capacitors come with a resistor. Some you can see, like this one, but most often not. It is molded into the cap and you can't see it. This allows the capacitor to bleed down and not weld the contacts in a relay or contactor. Whenever you check a capacitor, remember they can be charged and give you quite a jolt of electricity. It is recommended using a resistor to bleed down the capacitor and not a screwdriver. Using a screwdriver can ruin the capacitor. Also, if you find a bad capacitor, check the contactor and potential relay for damage. Often the two go hand in hand. Most new multimeters will check the capacitance of a capacitor, or you can use a capacitance tester. Let's take a closer look at this capacitor. It is a dual run, 25 microfarad to the compressor and 5 microfarad to the outdoor fan motor. Also notice it has a tolerance of only 3% either way. In other words, it needs to measure 25 and 5 or it is bad. On a capacitor start motor, if the start capacitor is open, the motor has no run capacitor. The motor will hum and fail to start since the start circuit is open. It would be the same as not having a start winding at all. On a PSC motor, if the start capacitor is open, the motor may start when lightly loaded, but will hum and fail to start when loaded. If the motor fails to start, it will cycle off with the overload protection device. Checking a run capacitor is different than checking a start capacitor. Using your multimeter, loop the common wire and check your amp draw. Then, carefully disconnect a wire from the run capacitor. If the run capacitor is good, the amp draw should go up by about 50%. If the amp draw does not change or only changes by a small amount, you have a bad run capacitor. Reconnect your wire and the amp draw should go back down and the motor will run smoothly.